All right, this is lesson number two, class. Now, before you begin, please make sure you understand the key words for this lesson. Functional grammar is not new. It began in the 1960s, mostly through the work of Professor Michael Halliday. And since then, functional grammar has been developed around the world and continues to grow in popularity. However, most learning materials still use traditional grammar. In traditional grammar, the view of language does not look very far past parts of speech. In functional grammar, parts of speech are called classes because they classify the words. You probably already know the basic classes, but let's take a moment to review them anyway. Okay, so nouns are naming words such as koala, collection, and area. And how can you tell if a word is a noun? If you can modify the word with articles and adjectives, it is a noun. So a suitable area and the amazing collection. We have area is a noun and collection is a noun, because we can put an article and an adjective in front of those words. But this test doesn't work for pronouns such as he, it, that, and which are also a type of noun. Verbs are action words such as eat and chase, mental words such as want and hope, relational words such as be and have, and other words that express saying, behaving, and existing. There are also auxiliary verbs that modify the main verb, such as can, is, and would. Verbs have many forms. The basic forms are listed here. So we have the base verb, such as want or eat, the infinitive with to want and to eat, the present participle, which is the ing form, and the past participle, which is generally an ed or an en ending. Many past tense verbs have the past participle form, but there are also many irregular past forms, such as ate. Adjectives are words that modify nouns, usually describing or classifying them. So, a suitable area. Suitable is the adjective, and a splendid garden. Adverbs are non-verbs that modify verbs, adjectives, and other adverbs. So in number 8, directly across the road, and in number 9, usually and alone are both adverbs. Conjunctions are words such as and although that join units of language together. So here are a couple of examples. And prepositions are words such as across, in, and to, that show various relationships, especially space and time relationships between nouns. And finally, articles are just one class of words that modify nouns by referring to them in certain ways. And I'm not going to go into this just now because it's pretty complicated, but basically there are three articles in English: a, an, and the. So this has been a very short review of the classes. I'm sure there are many more examples that I didn't include. Now in the next lesson, you will learn how class is different from function.